Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Sugaring. Valentine's is just around the corner, so I'm bringing you a really easy to make chocolate cake recipe which you can make in just a pan. You don't need a cooker, not an oven as well. So a very easy chocolate cake recipe for you to make for your better half. So let's begin. If you are new to the channel, make sure to click the subscribe button and ring the bell icon so that you get a notification as soon as I post a new video. And now we're going to begin making the crepe cake, for which we're going to take a bowl and add in the plain flour and maida to this. I'm taking 1.5 cups of maida, followed by the cocoa powder, powdered sugar, and baking powder. That's about it. I'm going to mix all the dry ingredients really well. Now I'm going to mix a few wet ingredients as well, for which here I have a cup of milk, to which I'm going to add in 1 teaspoon of vinegar and 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. You can also use 1 teaspoon of lemon juice if you don't have vinegar in hand. I'm going to mix it really well. What next? We're going to add in the milk and vinegar mixture to the dry ingredients or the plain flour mixture. Along with that, I'm also going to add in 1/2 cup of water and 3 tablespoons of melted butter. That is all we need to add. Now I'm going to mix all the ingredients really well, and our batter will be ready to make the crepe cake. Alright, so what next? What we're going to do is take a small ladle or a small measuring cup like this, and then we're going to use this to pour the batter to the fry pan. You can even use a tawa if you want to. I'm using a small fry pan like this. If you're using a fry pan, make sure it's not curved to the sides and kind of sharp in the sides. You can even use a ring mold if you want to in this recipe. I'm going to heat up this fry pan and we're going to pour in the batter. So I'm going to pour in about 3-4 tablespoons of batter to this fry pan, and I'm going to swirl it around. And we're going to cook this in medium flame until the top is perfectly cooked. So my crepe cake looks cooked from top. I'm going to just flip it around. So just about 30 seconds on the other side, I'm going to get this out now. So like so, I'm going to make all the crepe cakes with the batter. So all my crepes are done. Just a small tip to you when you are making the crepes is that make sure the crepes are very well done before flipping them off, otherwise they can break. And now we're going to prepare the whipping cream for the crepe cake. So I'm using whipping cream for this recipe. I'm adding about 300 milliliters of this whipping cream. You can also use powdered whipping cream in this recipe. They come in packs like these and they are very easily available in the market, and they are available online as well. I have used them personally. They work perfectly for this recipe. Next up, what we're going to do is grab a whisk and whisk it all up. So that's about it. My whipping cream is also ready. Now I'm going to refrigerate it for about 10 minutes or so, and then we're going to assemble the cake. So what next? We have prepared the cream and the crepes. What we're going to do is flip the crepes around, that is top to bottom, so that we can take it out easily, and to keep it aside. And to assemble the crepe cake, what we're going to use is a turntable like this. If you don't have a turntable, don't worry. What you can use is a bowl, which you can place a bowl like this, and you can place a plate over it, and you can assemble it the same way. I've used this several times and it works perfectly. You can just turn it around like this. So what I'm going to do is just dab a little bit of the whipped cream into the turntable at the bottom, just a little bit of it, and place in one crepe, and then I'm going to add in a little bit of the whipped cream and spread it around. The amount of whipped cream is totally your preference, little or more. Just repeat the process. A dollop of cream and spread it around.
And the last one. What I'm going to do next is cover this really well with the whipped cream. So just going to spread it around everywhere. I'm going to cover the sides as well. So just going to lightly cover them.
So I'm going to place in the strawberries in the top now. I've got some chocolate as well, which I'm going to place in on top.
So the cake is almost done. The next step is to get this out of this turntable. If you are using a plate, then you are all good. You don't need to do this. You need to just get this out. Perfect. The final thing to do would be to place in strawberries in the side. So let me do that. That's about it. Your crepe cake is all ready. You can also coat the sides with ganache and totally skip the strawberry part if you want to. But I like the slight fruitiness that the strawberry brings in. So this is the way I prefer it. Hope you try it out the same way. Time to serve it up. Can't get better than this. The creamy whipped cream, the slightly tart strawberries and the soft chocolatey crepes together are a bomb. So make sure you try this out and let me know how it goes for you. And a fun question to end it all up. Count down the layers and let me know how many layers are there in this crepe cake. I myself haven't counted so far. So comment down below and let me know how many layers are there in this cake. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to watch more and subscribe. Bye. Take care.